In this video, I'll be doing a review of the Canadian Prepper's Bug Out Roll. I'll discuss where this product fits into a Prepper's gear lineup, what makes it unique, I'll show you what I'm using it for, and at the end of the video, I'll share my thoughts on the roll. Also, a quick note, this is not a paid review, and I actually purchased this roll myself. I believe in supporting the Prepper community, and I believe this gear is not only worth the purchase price, but I'm glad to support a fellow Prepper that provides invaluable information to the Prepper community. So let's jump in. To begin with, while this piece of gear is very innovative, I'm not expecting it to replace my bug out bag, EDC, or get home bags, but rather it's designed to serve alongside of them. I'm personally using it to store and maintain a lot of the extra gear I have that I want to take in the event I would have to bug out, but didn't have a place to put the gear in my current setup. Every person will use this roll differently, and the items I added to my roll will undoubtedly be different than what you would use it for. The most unique feature about this roll is that it allows you to see everything quickly and allows you to organize your gear. No more digging around a bag trying to find things. You'll be able to see things quickly and be able to easily get what you need. It also has a hanging tab that allows you to hang this up, making access to the items even easier. So here's the items I have in my roll. Again, this is unique to me, and you will probably add completely different gear, which is the beauty of this roll. I'm using this mostly to store backup items I already have in my existing bug out bags, along with some other items I want in my bug out bags but didn't have really enough space for. Having these items ready to go alongside my bug out bag gear will make heading out quickly all the more easier instead of having to hunt these items down. Alright, so start off with, I've just got a simple bandana, some money, chapstick, lip balm, and some USB drives with some important information document. The next thing is some Mylar blankets, just space blankets. Again, these can serve a lot of different purposes, but obviously the primary is to keep you warm. Got some tush wipes. I think they're pretty self-explanatory. The SAS survival guide. The next section is kind of like a lighting area. Just got some basic LED flashlights, some glow sticks. Again, these can serve a really useful purpose. Next, we have kind of a assortment of different tools to use to start fires. I've got some, you know, kindling there that you can shave off. I've got a knife sharpening tool, some matches with a striking surface, some iodine water purification tablets, some wet fire to get your fire going really quickly. Next, we've got some basic medical items. We've got some aspirin 500 milligram, some band-aids. Got some sewing needles. I need to add some sewing material alongside that, but it can be used for a lot of different things. A few different creams I have for medical situations. In this pocket, we've got a lockpick set, some extra batteries. All right, got a Leatherman Wave. This is a multi-tool I've had for years. I've also got some different options here where you can put in different items. Got a few walkie-talkies. You've also got some additional pouches. You can put so many different things in here. In one of the pouches, I've got my ham radio. In this next set of pouches, I've got some different ammunition, a few magazines for my M4 with 5.56. Also got some additional ammunition for my 9mm pistol. In this next area, I have an assortment of different items. Kind of some random material, to be honest. Got a compass. Got a cat tourniquet, fixed blade knife, I have some basic mask, got some zip ties and super glue, and I've also got an additional antenna for my ham radio to help extend the range. All right, and these last two pouches, which by the way are add-on modules, you can take these off if you want. There's Velcro that allows you to pull these off. This first pouch, I've got water filter, got some work gloves, got some paracord. Got a Silky Boy saw. Thanks again to the Canadian Prepper for sending that out to me. And in this last pouch, I've got a few other medical items. I've got a cold compress and a hot compress, along with a bandage and some additional first aid item. So there you have it. Those are the items that I chose to put in my kit. And again, you'll probably add different items, but but those are some of the ones that I decided to add in. So here's my final thoughts on the bug out roll. I think the Canadian Prepper came up with a very innovative approach to allow people to organize and store their gear in such a way that they could quickly access what they need. The one thing that may catch people off guard is the price. It comes in at about $100 plus shipping. But as he's pointed out in several of his videos, he purposefully chose to produce them in North America to create jobs, and he wanted higher quality instead of outsourcing the manufacturing overseas. And the quality definitely shows when you handle it. He didn't cut corners. The material is well sewn, uses heavy-duty zippers and thick material. Beyond just the prepper community, I could definitely see some uses for this, like in the medical community, where first responders need to access specific gear very quickly. Having the ability to see everything at once could be critical when seconds matter. I'll provide some links to videos the Canadian Prepper produced showing different uses for the roll. Personally, I like this roll quite a lot. I haven't had an opportunity to take it camping yet, but we'll be taking it out soon. I'll provide a link in the description section below where you can pick up one of these bug out rolls. And I'd also like to hear your feedback in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, please feel free to like or share on social media. As always, be safe out there.